In 1983, David Cronenberg showed his audience The Dead Zone. The US production with an R rating made its cost of $10 million alone in America two times back. It won several awards and received quite consistently positive reviews. It has a number of top spots in my favorite lists. Best Stephen King adaptation with a fantastic element, best Cronenberg movie with a fantastic element, best soundtrack in a Stephen King adaptation, best performance ever by Christopher Walken. The movie is based on Stephen King's seventh novel, The Dead Zone, from 1979. It's largely in line with the movie, but much more detailed, as with the backstory of Johnny, who experiences in the original a serious ice accident as a six-year-old, which his mental gift, also much more public interest for it, got possibly triggered by. Or the prehistory of Greg Stilson, who is introduced as a book agent and, among other things, kicks a dog to death. There are also some plot lines left out or trimmed for the movie, and some things were added and made more dramatic. In the novel, there is no child in the flames, the apartment is during the fire empty. Frank's mother doesn't shoot Johnny either. In his accident, Johnny is not driving himself, but took a cab. Johnny's visions are also less specific, and unlike the movie, he is not part of them. As the young teacher Johnny drives home through stormy weather, he has a car accident that leaves him for 5 years in a coma. When he awakens, he has the supernatural ability to see past and future. Simply by touching objects or people. When he envisions the US president by a deliberate nuclear strike against Russia,
my destiny,
destroying the world. So exactly what election fraud Biden is currently planning.
It is not necessary, Mr. President. We have a diplomatic solution.
The missiles are flying.
He must prevent this at all costs. You okay, Greg? The genius soundtrack by Michael Kamen was back then even harder to get than the Rare movie itself. It took years before we got, out of pure luck, a clean recording. When we saw the movie for the first time, we were similar to Carpenter's Assault, baffled by the unbelievable lovelessness how this brilliant masterpiece was shit out on video. As if it were not already bad enough to cut parts of the picture to get the awful 4:3 ratio, they even left out a few seconds from the beginning. And of course, there were also the usual censoring cuts. What else? Dead Zone is one of the best movies I know, and belongs to the very rare cases in which it not only matches the very good novel, but even surpasses it. The idea to put Johnny in his visions is awesome. The practical effects hold up even today, since they have been used carefully and are not the focus of the story. That is the charismatic lead. Also, the villain part benefits from a good cast, in which Martin Sheen convinces as a hell of a slimy politician.
God has seen fit. Bless you with this gift, you should use it.
Bless me?
You're a devil. Son of a man.
Who are you?
Who sent you?
I'm scared, sir.
What's happening to me?
We're gonna get married, Johnny. Don't leave me, please.
Didn't you see how clear it all is? Not only can you see the future,
I can change it.
Nelson! Nelson!
I was there, I saw it.
Put your hand on the scanning screen and you'll go down in history with me.
I saw his face.
I stood there. I did nothing.
Johnny!
Perfect life.
2002, Dead Zone came out as a TV series with 80 episodes, 45 minutes each in 6 seasons. The entertaining series is based loosely on the novel, changes some relationship constellations, introduces new characters, and shows what would be if Johnny did not shoot Stilson, but instead trying to find another way.
You should see what I see.
The assassination appears in a vision Bruce has with Johnny's help in the 12th episode in the second season, which shows what would have happened if he hadn't met Johnny. Worth mentioning is episode 14 in the second season, named simply Plague, in which Johnny just predicts the coronavirus. There's talk of possible similarities to SARS, with flu-like symptoms, that it comes from China, airborne transmission, that masks are of course useless, but everybody knows that anyway, it is only a slave symbol, or with us, an order follower retard recognition sign, and the people are cured, no joke, with chloroquine. Yes, you have heard right, the stuff pharma prostitute Trump runs on the pharmacy dash for. Pharma whore Biden, of course, is running for the vaccine pimps. So, as usual, the choice between plague or cancer, thanks to the worldwide corona scam to reduce and enslave humanity, among others through poison injections fraudulently called vaccinations, by our world destroyer demons from hell. And their state-funded terror organizations like WHO and co. For more information on Fascism 2.0 and the New World Order since March 2020, just look out of the window or watch the COVID 1984 videos. Best on currently still relatively uncensored platforms like my Telegram, BitChute or Odyssey channels, which are also called the Lone Wolf Cup and in the original German version Der Japango. The series has way too many episodes and so it often drifts away from the very interesting main story and shows instead too much crime of the week cases. The last season seems like thrown out quick and cheap, and worst of all, even with a cliffhanger ending. The success of the series also led to The Simpsons Treehouse of Horror 15 segment The Net Zone in 2004. In the very funny episode, Ned Flanders has constant visions of people dying after a tragic accident. In the same year, South Park Season 8, Episode 13, Cartman's Incredible Gift was another persiflage on the Dead Zone series, in which everyone after a coma accident is suspected having a second sight. And the police are only able to solve their cases with psychics.